Is
okay.
Hello everyone, welcome. Let's see if you're all in this meeting, in this live stream, if you're following it. Did I get it wrong?
15 are watching now.
Yes, there are 15 watching right now, so that's good. While we're waiting for the rest to drop in, we can already start by explaining some things we're going to use. For instance, for here, as you can see, we've got all the paints on the nice bit of carton, which you can use and blend later on. And you all got the brush we're going to use, and we've also advised you to use a card. For example, I'm going to use this old card from the Canada Bay. We're going to cut it up in three pieces. The first piece is going to be 1/5 of the card. We're just going to cut it right through. And then the other half, we're going to cut it through half. So it's around 2/5. So you get three nice pieces you can work with. These we're going to keep for the end of for later on in the stream, because you're going to need them for painting some items. You all also received the bingo card with things Bob Ross said. The game with playing this is when you hear something on your bingo card, you can cross it off and take a sip, and if you got a full row, you can hand out 5 sips to someone of your choosing, either who you're painting with or someone in the Discord. So you can also drink a bit during this activity. The rest of what you will need is some water to clean your brushes and a paper towel is also highly advised.
Yeah, I don't know how many now are watching.
There are 18 watching right now. But yeah, I think we can.
Do we start?
I think we're going to wait a little bit longer to make sure that everyone is here. So. Take a beer. Make sure you have a beer with you for during this activity, because if we're going to do it right, you're going to take a lot of sips with the bingo card. So. Let's see how many are here right now. 21. It's starting to look like it. Some of them need to grab some scissors.
Nice.
And we also have one more announcement. He didn't want me to make this, to say this, but there is someone, it's someone's birthday today. So if he's in the Discord, make sure to celebrate and sing a song for him, because it's Jeffrey. So make sure you find him in the Discord and sing a song for him. He really likes it. He doesn't hate me after this at all, so. Sorry, Jeff. He's going to hear this first.
Okay, so we are now waiting for some more people to join, and we will explain again the painting tools that you will need, so everyone is
and,
having everything.
Jeffrey is in room 17, so make sure you join that one so you can start and sing a song for him. Maybe he wants to come downstairs.
22?
It's starting to look like it.
Maybe he's going to
20. Instead of 21 again. Okay, in a few minutes I'm going to start explain the tools once again. I'll explain it in a minute again if more people join. So everyone knows what to do. Ik denk dat je het heel leuk vond dat ik dat zeg.
Heeft hier.
Wait, for some the link Discord doesn't work. I'll send it again. Nog in de kop geweest. Okay. If it's good, this one will work.
Okay, so I think we're ready.
Yes. So I'm going to explain the tools once again. Of course, first thing you'll need is of course the canvas and which you're going to paint on. Then we have the paint. We have six different colors, and with these six you can make the entire painting. You of course all have the brush we gave you. You're going to need a old card, for example the Canot Bay card. You're going to want to cut it up in three pieces like I did here. These ones these are used later on in the painting for some items. And of course some water for which you can clean the water with. And a paper towel and clean the cards. We've also given you each the bingo card. The game is if you hear one of these sayings, which Bob Ross said, you tick it off. Every time you hear one, you drink, and when you have five in a row, you can hand out five sips. So you can all start now by ticking off the free space and enjoy your first of hopefully many sips this evening. Okay. How many are there now? 24.
Yeah, I think people are watching it together.
Yeah, I think so too. Okay, so I think we can start.
Yeah.
And of course, I think in each of us, something in our life just wants us to paint a picture. That's why we're doing this tutorial for the Bob Ross activity.
Yes. Yes, okay. So first we start by covering the whole canvas white. So just let's begin with that.
Yes.
Just take a little bit of water and then a little bit of white, not too much.
Then just paint across the whole canvas to make it white.
Nice layer of white, so this will help us in the future to bring the landscape more alive, to have more depth in it.
And if you ever during this workshop think that you're not good enough, just always remember talent is a pursued interest. Anything that you're willing to practice, you can do. So if you don't think this is good, you can always watch the stream back, I think, and then you can try again and see that it keeps going better.
Okay, I think I'm almost done.
Yes. So now we've painted the whole canvas white. This will, as said before, bring out the entire bright side into the painting later on with the landscape.
Yeah.
Okay,
yes.
Okay, so now we're going to paint the sky. For the sky, we're going to grab the blue color. First, we're going to wait a little bit to make sure everyone is ready. So between every step, we'll take a small break so everyone can catch up, because we understand if you aren't up to speed with the space we do it in, since we've practiced this before. So. Okay, I think everyone is done. So now we're going to take a little bit of blue color. Just put it on the brush. Yes, now just start in the corner and make sure you make a crisscross pattern like this. And in the top, do it a little bit more paint than in the bottom. Make sure you grab some paint during this, some extra paint, so you can make a nice different color sky everywhere. Crisscrossing just all the way around 1/3 of the painting down to that. Try to keep it right on the bottom side and a little bit more dark on the top side. You can also keep some darker spaces over here, as you see, to make it a little bit more realistic.
So, as you can see, Patrick is now doing crisscrossing with his brush. He's just letting his brush doing the work. You have to make sure to make love to the canvas and don't overbrush it.
So, as you can see now, it's done. After this, after doing the sky, we're going to the other blue bit, that's the water. So for this, of course, you first need to clean the brush, just dip it in the water. Make sure it cleans really well. And then just grab some paper towels to make it dry. We can beat the brick to make it dry to get everything out. You can see we're doing here.
Oh, I managed to smell.
It's going too fast?
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to wait a little bit longer than between the pieces, between the steps. Because we want to make sure everyone gets up to keeps with us. And if you ever think during the stream I can't do it, I think there's an artist hidden at the bottom of every single one of us, so keep trying, and I think at the end you'll make a great result. Make it turn up the sound, because On our side, it seems to be working well. So.
Okay, so now we have covered the whole canvas white and make some crisscross movements with blue to paint the sky. And in the meantime, I think in a minute we will do the water.
So, I think most of you will be ready by now. So I think we can move on to the next step after this.
Oh. What does the chat say?
Come okay. Now that I think if you do that, you'll hear yourself, and that's not really a great thing. You can ask the questions in chat, and we'll answer it.
So next step is to paint the water, that we do by this color. Just take a little bit of blue. And a tiny bit of green. Not too much, because otherwise the water will look very greenish and that's not what you want. Okay, so I think now we have a nice blue color. okay.
Yes.
Okay, so to creating the water. So to creating the water, we blend from the we start at the outside and then we blend in like this. We need a little bit more paint. From the outside and then we blend in.
Make sure you leave a little bit of a white space in the middle, which will be the reflection in the water.
Okay.
So push a little bit more around the outside, pull it inwards, and make it a little bit, lower your touch. So you get a nice effect that it gets less dark in the middle.
Yes.
Make sure you find the freedom on the canvas.
So as you can see in the middle there's a white space.
Yes, okay.
Yes, I think we're done. Okay, so make sure to also cross a little bit over the white space, because we don't want to be it fully white, but just to create the reflections. And you, as you can see, water is very quiet. Water is like me, it's lazy. Boy, it always looked for the easiest way to do things. Nice.
Okay, so we'll wait a little bit more for this, for you to complete this step. And then we'll be moving on. And make sure if you hear a quote you have on your bingo card, just take a sip. And if you have bingo, make somebody else drink. Because everyone has a personalized bingo card. So you can have bingo at other times the other players have it. And if you've listened well, you've already could have heard around 6 quotes at this time. Yes, after this, after doing the water, we're going to go back to the sky. We're going to paint the clouds. For the clouds, you once again just going to take a little bit of white and just put it around here, and a very tiny bit of red in it, so you can create a little bit of a sunny effect. Not too much, you almost can't see it on camera, but there's red in there, so you get a nice sunny feeling to it. And for cloud, you're going to want to have to paint on the corners of the brush. Okay, so when you go to the painting, you're going to want to use the corner of the brush, this bit, just push it down and make circles with it. Maybe a little thing. And just make circles with it. Try to make it a little bit more white on the top side and a little bit less pink on the bottom side. When you're done with that, you're going to want to create another one, just somewhere where you want it. Just paint a happy little cloud. When you're done with that, you want to clean the brush. And when you're done with that, just make sure you want to go over the clouds once more with your brush once it's clean and dry. Just go from the bottom up, and also on the other side, from the bottom a little bit up, and then blend it a little bit at the bottom with the clean surface brush, so it just feels right with the, it blends in with the cloud. And always just remember how free clouds are. They just lie around the sky all day long. And once we've done this, we're going to add one more little cloud, just for the fun of it, because it looks nice. So you can still see little bit circles. We don't really know where this goes, just put it anywhere you like. It doesn't have to be in these spots. Since you're the artist, you can create it the way you want it to. Just push it upward a little bit. Try to blend it into the bottom. Yes.
Okay, so as you can see, Patrick created three clouds with using the corner of the brush and making circles, and then with a clean brush he blend the bottom of the clouds into the sky, and he flipped the clouds a little bit more upwards.
As you already can see over here, it's starting to look quite good from the far view. Because when you look pictures close up, sometimes it doesn't really look like anything. But when you see the full picture, it will look good. I'm going to wait a little bit since you asked some questions in the chat. We'll just wait a little bit. And if you want, you can let us know in chat how it's going so far. If you're following the steps, if it looks kind of a bit the same like ours, or if it looks totally different, we're kind of curious to see how it goes with all of you. And after the next step, we're going to take a little bit of a longer break. So you can get a new beer, go to the toilet if you want, or catch up if you need to.
Yes, and now? Okay, so in a minute we will create the mountains. Oh, nice, you have happy little clouds. That's good to know, to hear. Yeah. Take the mountains too?
Yes.
Oh, God. Okay, so for the... Okay, so for the mountains, you need 1/3 of the card that we cut before. For the mountains, we take a lot of colors and we mix them together. So we start by picking the black color. And then blue. A bit of red. Oh, it looked allemaal. Oh. Okay.
It walks. Everything walks.
A little bit of yellow. Yellow. A little bit of green. And then mix it together. I don't know if you can see it. Mix it well, we don't want to have rainbow mountains. They need to look a little bit realistic. Okay, so when you have mixed your colors, okay, maybe I can do this better over here.
Yes.
Can you?
Yeah. We'll switch to the other camera.
Yes. Okay. So as you can see, I've mixed my colors. Oh, under this light, it looks a little bit green. I don't want that. Okay.
It looked a little bit like green, so we're going to add a little bit more black and blue to make sure it's dark. Don't use too much paint for this, because you'll only need a few mountains.
Okay, so the next thing you are going to do is you pull your paint.
Just
you will pull it straight down. Push it up. And after that.
Yes. Yes. This is good.
After that, you will cut across like that. And this will create a nice edge of paint on your card, and that will help us by creating and smoothing out the mountains. So when you have that, we'll go to the canvas. And yeah, now you have to make a decision where you have to put the mountain. You put your card like this and touch the canvas, go slightly up, and then swipe it out. And make sure to add paint on the same with using the same techniques by flattening out, cut across, and again creating another mountain over here. And maybe a mountain over here. Okay. So I hope you're doing fine with that. Now we're going to rip off all the paint.
And be very light, just be a gentle whisper with this part.
So I would love to hear from you if you have this step so far.
If you have this step, we can move on to the next one. Luke, you need like a card, you can cut up your own card, which you can use. We have used, for example, you can see here like a Canal de Bay card, which we cut up earlier at the start of the stream. And this is what we use to mix the paint, and this is also what we use this step. So it's not like it's a missing brush.
If you don't have a card like that, you can also try to use a knife from your kitchen. Maybe that will also work. Just try it out. Be an artist.
But with a card, it's a little bit more precise, and it's a little bit more like a painting knife, which you actually want to use, but we don't have. Okay, he understands it now.
Okay, so now we're going to use a clean brush and blend the bottom of the mountains out to create a misty area.
With this, you're going to create like a little bit of a shadow or a mist, so it looks a little bit further back in the painting. Yes, okay. After we've done this step, we're going to create the snow on one side of the mountains. For that, you're just going to need a little bit of white. So you just scoop up a little bit of white, put it somewhere. Then, once again, just cut across so you get a nice little edge of paint on it. And after that, you're going to have to, want to choose which side you want to put the snow on. This is important because on one side you have the sun, so the snow will be white, and the other side it will be a little bit darker since it's the shadow, because you need this way you can really show the mountains and it comes really out of the painting. And you also need the light in order, you need the dark in order to show the light. So you can take the brush, the card, just gently from here. We're going to choose the right side of the sun comes from here. So we're going to put the light side on this side. A little bit, a little bit too much paint, so just put a little bit less. Just put it down from here. Make sure you don't have too much paint on it, because then it will be totally white. Just gently pull it down. Okay, now we're going to do that as well for the second and third mountain. Just from the top, just put it down to make sure you show the light. And over here you want to stop at the line which mountain this mountain stops, so you can really get the perspective that this mountain is in front of that one. Straight like this as well. So now it really looks, it's the perspective that this man is ahead of this one. Now for the final mountain, you can do the same thing. Third mountain, what I'm gonna do is also ahead of this mountain, so just put it straight down. Put it down. Right around here at the bottom, just let it fade a little bit. So this one, just make sure it fades a little bit. Okay, after we're done with this step, we're good. Yeah, after this step, we're going to create the darker side. So for now, this step, just take a little bit of white, put it on, and add a little bit of blue to it as well, so you get a nice darker color. As you can see here. Okay, so now put it on here, and then just once again, just cut across. Now we're going to do the darker side of the mountains. Now just from here, just pull it down a bit. Don't do it too hard, because then you'll scrape the paint right off. We don't want that. I'm going to do the middle mountain that's last, because it's the hardest one, because of the white on here over here. Yes. Now I'm going to grab a little bit more the mixture of blue and white. Then this middle part is the hardest one. Just put it down and try to stop it right at the white side.
Okay, so as you can see, Patrick has put some white on the sunny side of the mountains using the card, and a little bit of, by adding a little bit of blue to the white and put it on the shadow side of the mountains, this will create this view.
This will create the illusion that the sun comes from this side over here. Yeah. And it, in order for it to be a good painting, you need a clear perspective from which you're going to work from. And this one includes having a sun from one angle the whole painting throughout. And now, after this step, we're going to take a short break. Before this, we're going to take a clean brush and blend. Okay. Now we're going to just take a clean brush and blend it with the colors we just darkened the white, the bottom. And now, so we can create a nice little mist area as well here. Try to blend it. Just like we did before over here, just blend it a little bit. This will create a nice misty area, which we're going to use later on in the painting. Just turn, make circles, it's the best way to blend it. Yes. So as you can see now, the bottom side, it looks like there's a little bit of mist in front of the mountains, which means that it makes it look like the mountains are very far backwards in here, which we'll use when we're going to create things in front of here, just close up. Yes.
Okay, so maybe you're not done with the mountains, you are still working out with the card how it works. So we are going to take a break now, so you can do it in your own time.
Yeah, and we'll make the break long enough. I think we'll be back at 9, so you can catch up if you need to and go a little bit back if you missed a step. And you can also have a toilet break and get some more beer if you want to. So
yes,
we'll be back.
If there are any questions, just say it in the chat. So we will, in the YouTube chat, we will update you then.
Yes.
Okay, see you.
Okay, I hope everyone has had a break. I hope everyone has got the beer, has got done everything they wanted to do in the break, and caught up. Now we're going to make one little adjustment.
IPS of IPS?
Yes, sorry. Over here we made it a little bit too dark, so we're going to paint a little bit of white over it. So create a more, a little bit more, make the looks of a mist. So.
Oh, moet ik zo?
So we're going to add a little bit of extra white to create the illusion of a mist. Just tap a little bit, then blend it a little bit. So now it has a little bit more the feeling of a mist, which is good, which we wanted. Okay, the next step will be the trees. We'll have three different tree lines, which we're going to paint individually. Of course, first you need a clean brush. Make sure it's really clean, because we're going to use a lot of darker colors right now. Yes. And I like to beat the brush clean.
Beat the devil.
Just beat the devil out of it. No, for sure. Okay. So for this first tree line, we're going to make a little bit bluish gray with a hint of green. So we're going to take black, a little bit of blue, and a little bit of green, because these trees will be quite far in the back, so. And these will also be in the shadow of the mountain, so you won't really be able to see them. For this, you're going to need to fill the brush with paint. And in order to do so, you're going to want to wiggle the brush both sides, so the paint gets in the middle. And then just put it straight down. This way, I don't know if you can really see it, get a really nice sharp edge, which you'll need. Now, we're going to put down here, just put small little touches in order to create a tree line. I didn't fill the brushing up with paint, so I'm going to do that again to make sure it works out perfectly. Yes, I'll do it. I don't know if you can see. Do you hear it? You just wiggle it on both sides and just put it straight down. So now you got a nice sharp edge to it. It's really hard to show it on camera. Yeah, it's a nice sharp sharp edge. And with that, you can create these small little lines. And then just keep repeating that step. Just wiggling it. Bring it straight down for the rest of the trees. Especially in the front, it's important. Just grab a little bit of paint from the sides to push it to the middle, wiggle it, put it straight down. And we're going to create a little bit more of the color, because we're going to need quite a bit.
Yeah, the corner.
So create a little bit more of the color. Wiggle it to make sure it really fills with paint, and tree down to create a nice sharp edge. Then you start with the corner, you can try it. This doesn't really work. Create some trees. Remember, we don't make mistakes, we just have happy little accidents. So if something like this happens, don't worry too much about it.
Okay, so you use the corner of the brush and pull it down and tapping the canvas slightly to create those tree lines. The trees are far in the distance, so you don't have to worry that much to see all the individual trees. And when you go to the outside of the canvas, make sure to make the trees taller, so it will look more like a root picture. I was on the panel of fountains. Yes, okay, so now I think we've created the first tree line underneath the mountains. Do you want to do the...
Yeah, I'll try it. The first tree line didn't go that well, but no. Okay, so now for the second tree line. We're going to use the same color, except we're going to add a little bit more black to make it a little bit darker. Just grab some black. You can use the same brush, you don't really have to clean it since it's almost the same color, so it doesn't really matter that much. Just mix up the paint well. Just so wiggle it again. Just put it down. So this is all, this goes exactly the same first tree line. But for this one, yeah, no, we're going to start a little bit more. other one.
What?
Yes. We're going to start a little bit more here. And we're going to start a little bit higher, but we're going to go from here down to here to create the illusion that this tree line goes from behind the mountains in front of this tree line. Make sure you sharpen the brush. Thanks for the laugh.
Sorry. Don't make mistakes. Yeah, make sure you keep the misty area like that. You don't go through there with your trees, so that will create more views, more depth.
Yes, it is. Keep adding some trees over here, and then go a little bit more in front and just go around the midway to there, then this tree line is done. And the more tree lines you have, the more tree lines you have, the more depth you get into the painting, because then you have another plane, and increasing the amount of planes increases the amount of depth you see in the painting, so that is really good. You want to create a nice painting. Now I'm just going to continue this. A little bit back up more here, because it's quite light here sometimes. Just a little bit more, and then we're done with the second tree line. So just keep sure you keep doing this. So now we're done with this tree line.
Oh, anything with doors like that?
Yeah, so just make sure you clean the brush and get off the dish.
I think it's all over.
Yeah.
Not in there.
No. Just make sure. We're going to make it a little bit more to the left over here. I'm just cleaning the brush a bit because there was a little bit too much paint in it. You don't want that. Then you'll get like these smudges on here. So I'm just cleaning the brush right now in order to make it a little bit better to the left. There's a little bit more also here at the bottom. Just try to create the illusion that these trees are a little bit taller.
Yeah.
Okay, now we're done with this step.
I think we're going to wait.
Yeah, we'll wait a little bit for you to catch up with this step. In the meantime, we're going to clean our brushes to make sure we're ready for the next part. And if you have any questions, don't be scared to ask them in chat. We're happy to help you with this.
This can also.
Yeah. And isn't it great that, isn't it fantastic that you just can change your mind and create all these happy little things? Because first I just wanted to go here, but then I decided to go here, so you can just create everything you want. So it's your own imagination, this painting. You also don't have to follow these steps exactly as we do. You can create your own painting. So now I'll show you the painting for a bit to see how ours looks like. Then you can catch up if you're a little bit behind.
Twee bomen en bosjes. Dus daar en daar in. Ik zit niet echt.
And we'll continue in about 2 minutes to make sure you're caught up with these steps. Because I can understand if these steps are a little bit fast, if you first need to follow it and then just do it yourselves.
It's lost, how do we see when you work?
Yes, so now we're going to continue with the next part.
Yes, so now we're going to create a tree on the foreground. And we are going to mix a lot of painting colors again. You grab a little... We use a little bit of blue. A little bit of black, not too much. Some red. Some yellow. And some green. Make sure to mix this color well. We want the color to be brownish, so it will look like a tree color. I can see it in this light. Okay.
So now. Now we mix it. Each minute. So just. Yes, that's good.
Okay, I think I have what I want. So now we're going to take the brush, a clean brush, and reload the brush with a lot of paint. And then we will push it onto the canvas. I will show you how that works. Okay, so you load the brush with a lot of paint by making vertically strikes. By pulling your brush vertically down into the paint, you reload your brush with a lot of paint. Load your brush with a lot of paint. And next you will wiggle it like we did with the tree lines at the back. You wiggle it and pull it straight down to create this nice sharpened edge. And now you're going to make a decision where you want your tree to be. Okay, let's say we want to have it here. Tap on the canvas. Create your starting point of the tree line. And now we're going to use the corner of the brush. and just slightly touching the canvas. Huh?
Oh. Yet.
To create this nice tree. And make sure to leave those white spaces, otherwise you will get not the idea of a tree. And make sure to reload your brush with paint by wiggling it and pulling it straight down. Nice sharp edge. And now I will continue with my tree. Okay, and make sure to widen to. Okay, not more.
Make sure to leave the white space in between. Oh, make sure the it's like thin at the top part and just wider at the bottom side. So, like a tree normally does. Yes. Now we're going to wait a little bit again for you to catch up. And then after that we'll continue. So we'll put on the painting once again to show you how it looks like, so you can catch up and follow the steps accordingly. Now you can see the bottom part as well. So I think hopefully you're all done with this step. Now we're going to continue with the next step.
Comment of the brush.
The next step you can use the same brush as before. And we're virtually going to do the same step. So make sure You just pull it down first, try to load it, then wiggle it. Make sure you both sides you wiggle it well, and just pull it straight down to create a sharp edge. And afterwards, you can just you can put this tree wherever you want as well. I'm going to put it right next to this one. This is smarter. To create this.
Can't sit before.
Yeah. And then again with the corn. Oh. That didn't go as planned. So we don't make mistakes, we make happy little accidents. So for this, I'm just going to load it again, make it sharp, nice sharp edge. Just going to start a little bit higher. Then again, just with the corner. And now it doesn't look like it made a mistake. I just wanted the tree to begin higher. Exactly as planned. Now just. Again, just do the same as before. Make a nice little tree. Make sure to load it again. And of course, we gotta give the tree on the right side a friend, because everybody needs a friend. And of course, there's nothing wrong with having a tree as a friend.
We just need to quote.
Putting it a little bit more down here. Make sure you leave a little bit of empty water here at the bottom soil.
Nice.
Now this tree's done. We're going to create one last tree. So with this, you can use the same colors. Just grab a little bit more paint. Wiggle it. And put it straight down to load it. Now we're going to put this tree on the left side. Small touch. Now the corner of your brush. Just create a happy little tree.
Nice.
This one we're going to just make it dark all the way down here, because we're going to need that for later. So we'll put little bushes over here. So just put it on the canvas, just push it to the side, create a nice dark area. We'll color this in later. We'll highlight this later so it just doesn't look like a mess. But this is it for this step. So now we'll let you catch up again. We'll keep it on this screen so you can see what it looks like. Make sure to clean the brush well between this step and the next step.
I Okay, hoog 100. Okay, so I hope you have your trees on the canvas. Oh, 1, 2, 3. Oh my god. The next step is to create the trunks in the tree. We do this by first making a brown color. And yeah, that's by having some red. Give some yellow, not too much, and some green. And now we're mixing it. So, I don't know if you can see it. Okay, so now we have a nicely brown color. And you take a little bit of, you take the brown and you put it with some white. And now you're mixing it, but don't overmix it. We want to have that marbly effect for the trunks. So now I think my brown color is done. Yeah, now we're doing the same thing as before. You pull out your color. It's a little bit overmixed. Put it straight down. Cut across. To create a nicely loaded cart. And now we are going to do the trunks. You're creating the trunks by what? You're creating the trunks by touching.
Like cutting across.
You're creating the trunks by only a little touch. And then a little pool. I don't have enough paint, I see. What?
Okay, so just put a little bit of a trunk in the middle of the tree. Make it with white and brown. Just so you can visualize the middle of the tree.
And make sure to leave spaces with no trunk.
Yes, because of course sometimes the branches cover the trunk so you can't see the whole trunk. So be sure to leave some spaces as you do right now without the trunk visible.
Ja, het is een beetje te breed, oké? Okay? And maybe there goes a trunk inside the bush. Okay.
Nice.
Yeah,
we'll leave it.
The next thing we're going to do is to scratch with the corner of the card onto the canvas to create little, how do you say that?
Little twigs.
Yeah.
Within the brushes. Just grab a clean card and just scratch the paint off so you get the white of the canvas. We'll leave you with a little bit more time for this step, and then we'll move on. And then main part of doing this step, for example, these little twigs and these branches, is to make sure, because if I paint something, I don't want to have to explain what it is. I want the painting to speak for itself, so that you can see, when you see it, you can just immediately recognize what it is. Gives you a little bit more time. Okay, so for the next step, like the bushes we created here at the bottom, we're going to create them also on the right side. So I just grab the same color as you use for the trees and the branches. Just put it a little bit on your brush, and then just paint it a little bit darker here. So you get the feel of more bushes being there. Also a little bit towards the middle. Make sure you use enough paint for it to be dark. You want to leave the trunk over here, so it looks like the tree is really growing there. Just connect it a little bit up to those trees in the middle. This step shouldn't take too long.
Scratching.
Yes, and also right now, just as we did on this side, just take a card, try to scratch some branches in here.
Your hand.
You can get some nice little branches as well and dots in there. Short dots. sponsor on that, so it's your school. And after this step, I think you should be right already with this step, because we already had the paint and we already knew how to do it on the left side, so we can do it faster on the right side. So after this step, we're going to make a new color to highlight the bushes. First, we're going to get another piece of garden to mix it on, because the other one is quite full. But this is for highlighting the trees. For this, you want to add the color yellow to it.
To what?
Yeah, just grab yellow, grab some black, and also you grab some green. You can see here. And then just mix it up. This one is not really good, so I'm going to do it again, but I'm going to use less black right now, because that messes it up. Painting is also learning during the painting. As you can see right now, this color is a lot better than the one on the other side. Right now you just want to put it on the brush. You don't have to really fill it like we did before. Just get some on the brush. Then use the corner of the brush. You do need a sharp edge. You don't need it for the next step. So make sure I'm going to show you once again on this camera. Yes. Wiggle it nicely, then just pull it straight through. Then just I'm going to highlight this tree of here right here. Just put it on. Just pull it a little bit to the side, on top of the already existing. These, you get a nice lighter edge to that. Don't put it at the bottom, because of course that's where the shadow is, but just put it on the top. And also do the same step for the ones at the tree on the left side. Around the one over here where you put the branches, a little bit more green. Just make it seem a little bit more alive. And also the sun is shining on this side of the tree, so just a little bit light over there. And also don't forget this tree. That's also quite obvious. It's a little bit lighter on this side. Because if you put it more light on this side, you can show that this tree is in front, it's ahead of this tree, that the sun can get across this tree in front of it. Make it a little bit more lighter on this side, just a little bit darker on these sides, lighter on this side. Just also at the top, you can put a little bit. Also, just you're done with the highlighting of the tree. So I'll wait a little bit for you to catch up again. As you can see, the trees have got a little a nice color to it now.
Okay, so I think we can move on to the next step.
Yes. The camera's on you.
Okay. You can use the same brush and the same color, but now, but now just add a little more. Just now, add a little more of color to it to make it more like a happy place. Little squirrels can live and play in your painting. you can do this by adding some more yellow to it and more white. So that's what I'm going to do. So now we're going to highlight the bushes. So as you can see, I have a nice green color with a lot of touch with yellow. Just pull your brush in there, turn it around, so you have a lot of painting onto the top of your brush. And now we're going to touch the canvas lightly to create the highlights. You can play with this, you can look from what side the sun is from and what bushes are in front of others. So what I'm now doing is just touching the canvas lightly with this nice green-yellow color to create the highlights of the bushes. And maybe this bush will go also in front of here. And we also have some on the other side. And yeah, you can mix with your colors, maybe add some more red to it. To create another kind of bush.
Yes, and don't forget to make all these little things individuals, because all of them are special in their own way. and however you think it should be, that's exactly how it should be. So if you feel like it would be better doing it another way than we do it, feel free to do it.
Okay, so maybe I will add some more scratches to this one.
Yeah, because when you paint over it, the scratches sometimes go away. So be sure to maybe make some extra if it's necessary, so they stay in the painting. So now the bushes are done. We only have two small steps remaining. In order to make it the water seem like there's a void between the trees and the water, we're just going to grab the card and just grab a little bit of white. Just again, just draw a line, just scratch it across to get a nice little line. Preferably, you can use the smaller card, because then you can get smaller touches, which will make it look nicer. So then, what you can do is go in the middle of these three lines, just make a small little touch over here. Make a small little touch, which can make it look like the bottom side is the reflection in the water of those trees at the top. And then just also just put some small touches in the water to make it look like the sun is reflecting on the water a bit. Sure, use a little bit of paint because you don't want too many thick lines of it, because then it will look unnaturally. And the final one here is, and then finally with the, you're going to want a cleaner brush again, and just these lines in the middle, you want to smush them out a bit, and just blend them in a little bit, so you can make it really feel like it's a reflection, because now it just feels like a white stripe. That's not what you want. You really want it to feel like reflection. So now you just push a bit on it, make it smash a little bit, and then get a nice little line. So they make it feel like the bottom side is the reflection of the top side. Yes, and after this step, you only have one thing left, and this is of course the most important part of the painting, which is of course signing your name, because without your name signed on it, it's not really your painting. So just go to, for example, you can choose yourself here at the bottom right, you have a nice face for it, and at the bottom left. So I'm going to do it right here. I'm going to scratch it in. Just I'm going to take the card.
Oh, you scratched it.
So now just here at the bottom, just going to take it. Me, I'm going to scratch my initials in it. I don't know what Janine's going to do. She's going to do it right now.
Thank you.
can also choose to use the brush for this. But since you only have this brush, you cannot be too precise with this. So if you have like a smaller brush, you can do it. But with this brush, it won't be too nice. So because of that, we scratched it in. And after this, the painting is complete. Then yes, we will show you from close up. Yes. So, move a bit more backwards. This is our final result. We're very curious to see what your result looks like. Make sure to show the painting, to send a picture of your painting in the WhatsApp group so everyone can admire each other's painting. Yeah, so we're zooming into every little detail to show you how we did it.
Yes. Okay. So hope you guys enjoyed it.
And as I said before, make sure you post your pictures in the WhatsApp group. We're very curious, and we hope you had a pleasant evening learning how to paint, and for some others who already could paint, just getting inspiration how to use other techniques and just do it way better than we did. Quite possibly.
Okay.
I hope you enjoyed it, and see you.
Okay.